He's accompanied this evening on the piano by Miss Kyung-Eun Na. And is he ready to come out? I think so. Please, ladies and gentlemen, a warm round of applause for this next gentleman. His name is Adam Walden, everybody.
Joyous photo.
And when Louis sent it to me, he said that, I wish I knew what we were laughing about. I said, I know what we were laughing about. We were laughing because we had undoubtedly just played a whole phrase exactly together out of the blue, like we did a million times. And this tune that we're going to play, we recorded on Rainbow Mountain. Louis loved playing the tune. It's called Don't Speak. And I remember when we were playing in Sweden, at one point we played the high note, and we both held the note much longer than we normally did. And then the cutoff was just like, and I remember Louis, you know, I'm looking at him. He looks up at me and he says, but you know, Louis could drive me crazy too. I mean, he could be the most annoying person on the planet. And at the same time that we were so close in Blood, Sweat, and Tears, I remember we were on tour and we were in London. And we were so plugged in each other at one point that we were leaving the hotel and I was standing on, waiting for the elevator, and the elevator door opened and Lou was standing there and he looked at me and I looked at him and then, you know, he took some kind of perverse pleasure. And I remember one time recently talking to him when he had, like, you know, he never trimmed his eyebrow. And there was an eyebrow hair sticking in his eye. And he knows that I'm looking at him. You know, he's, how can you stand up? And he just wouldn't even acknowledge it. We just played, I feel very blessed because in the last month or 6 weeks of Louis' life, we did a record from our friend Tom Pearson of big band music. And so we were together for 2 weeks, 5 days a week, 6 hours a day rehearsing, recording this album. 4 days later, we left for Sweden and played 16 concerts in 18 days with George Bodinius, our old colleague, great guitarist, and a wonderful Swedish trio. And, you know, it was like the old days. We were traveling in a van, six of us. It was 2 hour, 4 hour, 6 hour rides. And there's four Swedes who have never heard our jokes. Lou, the last contact I had with him, I got a letter from, we both got an email from George explaining the shortfall in the projected income from this tour that we did. And I emailed George back immediately and copied it to Lou. And I said, you know, we were never in it for the money in the first place. We had a wonderful tour. We made beautiful music. We loved the band. We can't wait to come back. And Louis immediately texted me and said, I loved your response. It was really eloquent. And I texted him back and said, I was channeling you. And he texted me back and said, I love you. And that was our last bit. The funny thing is, typical Soloff, 2 days later, I went to look and the thread was gone from my phone. I couldn't find any of the sequence of text that we sent back and forth, but I loved him, and he loved playing this tune, and Randy and I played it once, and Mark and Danny were part of the band that recorded it and played it often, and you can't do better than Gil. Thank you. He introduced his parents and gave him his first trumpet when he was 9.
Favorite pieces. So it's a nice happenstance, and I hope you enjoy it.